Hello! Code & Solder is back with another video. This time, we'll take a look at this extremely cheap USB-powered soldering iron. It can be purchased for around $5 from a variety of Aliexpress sellers. This is the one I bought. Replacement tips are also available for around $1.5. It comes shipped in a box with a molded piece of plastic. Surprisingly good-looking packaging for the price. Apart from the iron, we also have a stand for it and a bit of solder. All of the instructions are printed on the cardboard. As we can see, it claims to be 100% high quality and professional, bold for something without even temperature control. We should also always remove power before changing the filter. Let's connect it to a power bank and see how it works. It did start melting solder within the claimed 15 seconds. I have tested the iron on both SMD and THD components, and both times it fired adequately, producing nice clean joints. I have observed one big downside though. The current on standby gets low enough that the power bank shuts down and needs to be manually restarted. After connecting it to the lab PSU, we can see that the standby current is around 4 milliamps and the working around 1.38 amps. This gives us nearly 7 watts of power, significantly less than the claimed value. When powering from the PSU, the iron is very sensitive to noise. Even turning on the lights or moving my hand close to the button can switch it on. The same occurs, though to a lesser degree, when powering from a phone charger. The tip replacement procedure is really very simple. You only need to unscrew the front cap, take the old tip out, put the new one in and screw it back. So in summary, the iron is good enough for some hobby applications, though a lot less comfortable than a full soldering iron, and the lack of temperature control requires a lot of getting used to. I recommend it only if you want to try electronics without investing significant amounts of money, or if you need something you can use while you're traveling. Otherwise, a normal soldering station is superior in every way. On the other hand, after adding temperature control, this could turn into a useful SMD tool, and in another video, we will do just that. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and comment what would you like to see next. You can also subscribe for more videos like this one.